Next up is my friend Pierre Chappaz. Please, Pierre, can you join us on stage? And I think Pierre has a presentation, actually. So Pierre is one of the best known, I don't know, I shouldn't introduce you, like one of the best known, you all know that he's one of the best known entrepreneurs in Europe, as Morten. And Pierre has news for us today. And I thought that the transition between Morten and Pierre was very interesting in this, you know, recession period, where I think you will like, you know, the news that Pierre has to share with us. So, Pierre,
thank you,
the stage is
thank
yours.
You, Loïc. Bonsoir, tout le monde. So, Loïc has asked me to share with you some optimism today. So, I would start by remembering you that this is not the first crisis we have been going through. I have been starting my first company, Quelqu'un, in 1999, 3 months before the internet crash. And if you remember, in 2000 or 2001, you could not even say to your friends or family that you were working for an internet company. Because for everybody, internet was dead. Startups were dead. And at the end of the day, what did we see? The strongest companies, the best teams, have been able to succeed and to build huge successes. It was the case for Quelqu'un until I sold it to Yahoo in 2004. This is why the title of my presentation is We Will Survive. Now there are concerns, there are challenges. The first challenge is because of this second internet crash, there is less financing available on the market, and advertising budgets are reduced. So it's more difficult to generate revenue for a startup. There is also a general assumption that Web2 services are losing money. And it's true in many cases that even the most well-known, and I'm thinking about American services, even the most well-known Web2 services are still losing money. But not all of them, and what strikes me is that most of them are making quick progress towards profitability. I was discussing yesterday with Oleg from Fotolia. I'm amazed by his numbers. He's profitable, he's building a huge business. It's a photo sharing marketplace. It's a B2B model. It's a model which works. It's a Web2 model. I was discussing earlier today with Freddy Mini from NetVibes. I am a shareholder of, and I am amazed of the speed of progress that has been realized thanks to Freddy Mini. Since he has taken over the responsibility of NetVibes, he has multiplied by 4 the quarterly revenue of the company in 3 quarters, and he's on the right track to break even next year. So although there are questions today on the market, what is the future of startups, and obviously not everybody will succeed, I want to share with you some facts about my venture, Wikio. Wikio is a pan-European news portal with local languages in 5 European countries and also in the United States. We launched 3 years ago in this country, and for those of you who were at LowWeb 2 years ago, you may remember that we launched during LowWeb for other countries 2 years ago. We are a team of 35 people. We don't have offices. We are a virtual network. People work from their home. Obviously, from time to time, we have a drink together. But we are a full internet company with people in several countries in Europe. The big question we had when we first visited VCs to raise funding for the company was, well, they were saying to me, Pierre, why do you want to make an information company? There is no money to make in information. Look at the information sites, everybody is losing money. So it was really the key challenge for us to be able to demonstrate that we can build a profitable business in the information field. And we were lucky enough to convince Lightspeed and Gemini to fund us. So first, The most important thing was to build a service which was attractive enough to be useful for the widest variety of users, not just geeks, not just men, not just women, but a service where everybody will find some interesting features. So we have been putting together, this is why I use the image of a Swiss knife, a very rich variety of features, indexing all the content which is published by media sites and selected blogs on the internet. We allow users to search this information, browse into this information, and find the most interesting pieces of information, whether they come from traditional media, from blogs, from consumer sites, from video sites. We are also famous for our blog rankings, which are updated every month and which are allowing people to find very quickly the most interesting blogs in each category: politics, technology, gastronomy, tourism, beauty, whatsoever. And we have included an RSS reader and powerful personalization features. I can say that I have learned from NetVibes and used some of the feature personalization features tabs from NetVibes to offer them to a wider public, which is the public of Wikio. We have been doing the same for the business model. We have a very pragmatic business model. First, we have two legs. One leg is an information business model, and the second leg is a shopping business model. With the same techniques, aggregation techniques, filtering techniques, we offer information services and shopping services. So our business model relies not only on advertising, not only on AdSense, not only on sponsoring, but also on merchant links. And you will see the numbers now, which are coming from my board presentation from yesterday. So these are the numbers I am presenting to my shareholders. First, the traffic is growing very, very fast. You see the curve here. We have reached more than 12 million unique users in November, including 4 million in this particular country, almost 3 million in Italy, and you see the numbers in all other countries. Then the revenue. You see, at the beginning of the year, we were making less than 40,000 euros per month. Clearly not enough to pay 35 salaries every month. We have grown up the revenue close to 200,000 euros per month in Q4. So you have all the numbers here. You see the quarterly revenue has been moving from 120 in Q1, 117 in Q2, 350 in Q3, 540 in Q4. And with 540, we are break-even. What you see also is the split of our revenue between information and shopping. It's pretty well balanced. Shopping is making 56%. Information is making 44%. So here you have the comparison between the cost and the expenses. We have been lucky because we have taken action very early this year to control our costs very carefully. So you see, we have been reducing our cost in Q1, while the revenue has been growing steadily during the whole year. So that in Q4, we are in the green. So a few learnings. First, believe in what you do and fight. Second learning is clearly, let's manage expenses very carefully, very carefully. This is an extremely competitive market, and even when a company is break-even, it doesn't mean that it will generate a huge margin in short term. You need to be very careful with expenses. Third, Europe is our natural market. We, as European entrepreneurs, we know that all Europeans are different. We know that the culture The needs of the users are different, and this is what makes it easier for us to open an internet service in other European countries. I think it's more difficult for our American friends. Now, two learnings more specific for Wikio. One, information generates a lot of traffic, but not so much revenue, while shopping generates much, much more revenue. So in fact, what we are doing with Wikio is leverage shopping revenue to invest in information services. As a conclusion, I would say that being an entrepreneur is like being a rock climber. You are always very close to the limit, but you are playing to win. Provided that you choose the right path, that you believe in what you want, in what you are doing, and also, obviously, that you work very hard. Thank you.
Thank you, Pierre. So, reaching break-even is a good way to go through a recession as well. Huh? You have raising funds and you have break-even. Thank you very much.